All right, so let's talk about the high-level interaction between the list view and the array adapter, and then we'll dive into the code in the next video. So you can think of a list view as being powered by the array adapter. So without the adapter, the list view is just an empty container. And when I say powered by, I mean that the array adapter holds onto the set of data that should be shown onto screen. So for example, it can hold onto an array or even a list of data. So the array adapter knows how to translate this data or adapt it into a list item view that will be displayed in the list view. So let's take a look at the details of how all this works. So when you first associate an adapter to a list view, the list view will ask how many items it should expect to display. And the array adapter knows this information. So the list view calls a method on the array adapter. And in this method, it will pass in an input, which is the current position in the list that the user is currently viewing. In this case, it passes in the position 0, but the user might be on the first position or maybe even the 100th position in the list. So knowing this information, the array adapter checks the internal source of data. So give this case, it checks the array. It might also check a list if that is the source of data. And it gets the information out, and it has instructions that tell it how to create a list item view that it will return to the list view. Now, when the screen is full, the list view will stop asking for more list items from the array adapter. So the list item views are only created on demand when needed. So when the views are scrolled off screen, remember that they're added to the scrap pile. So in this specific example, remember that Jane and Carl, the first two list items, are no longer visible and so end up in the scrap pile. And then we can actually reuse those views by passing them back to the array adapter when we request a new list item. So the list view will request the list item view for a certain position in the list and also pass along a view that was previously used before. So in this example, the list view is requesting for the item at position 6 and passing in the reusable view from before to the array adapter. Now the array adapter can use the recycled view by just replacing the data inside of it. For example, by calling the text view set text method to change the name here. And now it looks like a brand new list item that we can return to the list view to be added to the new hierarchy and displayed on screen.